Hey there, it's Andrew from the Clever Files team, and today I'm going to be sharing with you the top 7 ways to clear space on your iPhone. And by the way, before we start, if you guys end up enjoying this video and you want to see more like it, leave us a like down below and consider subscribing to the channel. So for this video, I'm going to be using my iPhone 14 running the latest iOS 17 version. And the first thing that I always like to do when actually freeing up space on my iPhone is to kind of take inventory of what kind of data is actually taking up space. And we can do this simply by checking our iPhone storage. So open your iPhone settings, hit general, then tap iPhone storage. And from here, you'll see a color-coded breakdown of what exactly is being stored on your iPhone and how much space it uses. And some of these are pretty obvious, right? You've got apps, pictures, music, etc. All of that is pretty straightforward, all except the system data or other category, but I'll explain that in a minute. Now diving into this particular menu further, you can actually see some of the tools iOS provides you to free up some of the space yourself. So something I do have access to is the ability to offload some of my unused apps, which I can do to free up a few extra gigs of space if I want. And now while I don't have these particular options for my iPhone, most people will also have the ability to use iCloud storage for their photos, as well as delete large iMessage attachments. And I'll be covering these in more detail in a few minutes. Now from here, you can also go into each category of storage allocation and individually review each one to determine which items are worth keeping and which are probably too big to keep around. So all of that is pretty straightforward, right? But what about the system data or other categories, right? Like this is one of the biggest, if not the biggest categories on your iPhone. So what gives? Well, in short, these are the files that your iPhone uses to run smoothly on a regular basis. Things like temp files, cache files, web logs, streaming data, essentially anything that isn't big or important enough to have its own category, but is still required by iOS to streamline the entire user experience. And as you'll find out in a few minutes later on in this video, deleting some of these files from this category can be a huge relief, not just to the storage of your iPhone, but also speed. So it's pretty awesome. And speaking of, let's get right into the tutorial bit of this video, starting off with one of the best ways to clear up space on your iPhone without even really thinking about it. And that's just clearing your browser's cache and data. So similar to our computers, the browsers on our iPhones will also store all of their browsing data, which can be cleared to free up a pretty good chunk of space, and not to mention improve browser performance as well. You could basically think of these as sort of junk files on your iPhone that can be cleared up very easily, but when you do, just know that your login and web data will also be deleted as well, unless it's saved in the iCloud keychain. So be aware of that, you will have to do a little bit of re-logging afterwards. It's not that big a deal, and to clear it, it's extremely simple, so here's how. Open your iPhone settings, scroll down until you find Safari, and open up the menu. And from here, just hit Clear History and Website Data. And that's it. Now you've just got a fresh Safari data log and a little bit of free space to go along with it. Okay, so moving on to method number 2, I call it app management, where it's really just managing the different apps on your iPhone and the data therein. But it's got a few different components to it that I'm going to be covering under one umbrella. So if I were to get more specific with this, I would call it clearing the cache of a particular app or a set of apps. That's really what we're dealing with here. So you can think of app cache in a very similar way to the cache in the browser we just cleared a minute ago. It's there to help the app run smoothly, but over time it can accumulate and slow the phone down, not to mention take up space. And there are really 3 ways to approach this. First of all, there are some apps such as TikTok and Amazon that allow you to clear app cache and other data from within the app itself, which is usually found within the privacy settings of the app in question. However, the second method, which applies to a majority of apps out there, is simply deleting and reinstalling the app. And while it's definitely more of a hassle, this is definitely the foolproof way to clear cache and data from any app and start with a clean slate. But of course, considering these two, it would be advantageous to just check each app individually and see which method would work best, either deleting the cache from within the app itself or deleting the entire app and re-downloading to start fresh. And also, just some food for thought here, it may be a good idea to consider leaving some of those apps off your phone entirely, as this will obviously be the best way to free up as much space as possible. Okay, so moving on here to method number 3, this is a really big one for me being a photographer, and that is clearing duplicate photos and videos off of your iPhone's camera roll. So this is a big one for me personally. As a photographer and videographer professionally, I always end up with way more photos than I need, and a lot of them turn out to be duplicates that are taking up literally twice as much space as they need to. So this is a super handy feature built right into iOS that allows us to handle this like that. So here's how you can do it. Go ahead and open up your Photos app, then scroll down to the Utilities section and hit Duplicates. Now I've already done quite a few here. As you can see, there's not much left for me, but all the duplicate photos and videos that are currently on your iPhone will be seen here. And all you need to do is hit Merge, and this will combine the duplicates and free up the space. Something I forgot to mention here is that if you want to take this to the next level, I would highly recommend checking out the app iOS Cleaner. It's a great solution that helps to clear up a lot more space on your iPhone, and it's extremely helpful for scenarios just like this one. So if you're interested, I'll leave a link down below in the description for you to check it out. All right, so moving on to method number four, we're going to be covering app offloading. And this is very similar to what we covered previously with app management, but just a little bit different and kind of the best of both worlds. So if you remember back in the iPhone storage menu that we looked at the beginning of the video, you could actually see a list of all the apps that are currently installed on your iPhone. You can go into each one, see how much space it's currently using, and there's also a button within that menu that you can use to offload that particular app. Now what this will do is it will take the app off of your phone to free up space, but it will leave the data intact. So if you ever decide to re-download the app later on, you can literally pick up right where you left off instead of starting completely from scratch. So it's kind of like a mix between deleting the app entirely and clearing the cache. It frees up space, but it also allows you to maintain the integrity of the app on your phone if you ever want to use it again in the future. Now this can be done by heading back to settings, tap iPhone storage, then either hitting the shortcut in the storage menu here, or by selecting an individual app and hitting offload. You can obviously do this for as many apps as you like, and this is a great way to clear up some space for apps you don't use but might use later on in the future, so you're totally protected. It's a pretty sweet feature. It's really clutch. All right, next up, let's talk about iMessage for a second, specifically removing large iMessage attachments. This one is huge. So iMessage can be a huge space eater without you even realizing it. The text threads themselves can get large, but it really gets nuts when you start to send and receive pictures, videos, and other attachments through text. And all of that stuff gets saved directly to your phone, which will continue to take up space. Luckily though, as always, iOS has a great built-in tool to help us deal with this. It will display all of the iMessage attachments on your phone by size, and you can clear them up on the spot to free up space. So once again, open up your iPhone settings, general, then iPhone storage. Then open up the iMessage window, and here you can review the largest photo and video attachments currently being stored on your iPhone that you have either sent or received. And all you need to do to clear them is hit edit in the top right, select the items you want to remove, then hit the delete button. This will clear them from your iPhone and clear up a pretty good amount of storage along with it. Okay, next up, we're gonna shift gears a little bit and talk about iCloud. Of all the methods on this list, this is probably your greatest bet for clearing up the most amount of storage at once. Saving photos, messages, contacts, notes, and other data to iCloud is fast, easy, and continuously frees up space on your iPhone for new content. And this, of course, becomes especially handy for photos and videos, which by definition are going to be some of the biggest files on your iPhone. And more specifically, when it comes to iOS, it has an optimized iPhone storage option, which is a bit of a smarter way to allocate space in the cloud itself. What this option will do is upload all original content to the cloud while keeping low res and other files on your device, which will automatically free up a lot of space on your iPhone. And then later, if you actually want the original files back on your device, you can hit download and keep originals, and that will actually download all of the original photos and videos back to your iPhone just the way it was before. And not to mention, once you set up iCloud with your Apple ID, that will also allow you to enable iCloud backup, which is a really nice safety feature for all your data as well. Okay, and finally rounding out today's list with method number seven, we can clear up a little bit more space by deleting duplicate contacts. So while these don't technically take up that much space, it is pretty annoying to have three of the same person saved in your phone. And it's just space that you could be using for something else that is being completely wasted. And so you can deal with it by doing the following. Open up the iPhone app, then hit contacts in the bottom center of the screen. Then after a bit, your iPhone will tell you how many duplicate contacts you have. Click view duplicates. And from here, you can either hit merge all or select which contact you want to merge individually. Hit merge and you're good to go. And with that, we're done. Those are the seven best ways to clear up space on your iPhone from junk files and various other stuff. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, always be sure to leave us a like, comment down below, let me know what you thought. Always love hearing from you guys. And if you have a specific question or concern, you can always contact us at help@cleverfiles.com. Thanks for watching.